Good evening, one and all present here. First, I thank God Almighty to give this wonderful opportunity to share my experiences with great people gathered here in the annual Computational Thinking Conference 2021 and hope we overcome this pandemic and back to regular lead. I am Mrs. Rajati Chandramohan from Vallal Esai Arhasami Chettiar Higher Secondary School, Royapuram, at Chennai in India. I am very glad to be a part of this conference. My presentation is on the topic Impact of CT Activities on Students' Learning During Pandemic Situation. When I want to say about my school, our school is located in North Chennai near the seashore. It is a government-aided upper primary cum higher secondary school with 30 teachers. Nearly 1,100 students are there in the school and our parents are fishermen and daily wagers. CT in Max was introduced in the year 2018. In our school locality, we can see women in groups play traditional games like dayam, that is throwing dice, pallanguri using tamarind seeds, and adupuliyattam, that is tiger and goats, in groups. During pandemic, children spend a lot of time watching movies on TV and playing games in mobile. So, to connect the context with curriculum, I introduce the activity Magic Triangle. My aim is to focus on unplugged activities and games which rejuvenate the children at home during lockdown. Coming to Magic Triangle, the word magic itself made children to think something fun, play a game and very curious to listen. I gave the simple task, that is to fill the numbers from 1 to 6 in the magic circles without repetition. So the numbers in all the sides of the triangle give the same sum. To warm up the children's mind for the Magic Triangle activity, I started with preparation step. Here students were allowed to discuss and share their views. As a result, they came up with number line, focus more solution in number operations, that is addition of numbers. It shifts the thinking process from regular to open-ended problem that relates to Magic Triangle. Student found more than one solution and emphasis multiple path of inquiry in problem solving. We can see students involved CT skills in preparation steps like breaking up numbers, strategy of choosing first small numbers and then large numbers, finally adding small number to large number to get the sum. Here we can observe analogous thinking beginning with identifying the correct path. Then step-by-step process, that is algorithm, leads to find the solution both in regular and open-ended problem. In the implementation step of Magic Triangle activity, students easily solve the Magic Triangle after practicing open-ended problems. Magic Sum 9 was done with the teacher's guidance in the online classes. Then students solve the Magic Sum 10 by themselves at home and send it through the WhatsApp group.
Hi everyone, today we are all put the Magic Triangle. You are all ready? So first, you draw the triangle in your chart. Okay, then you put the circle in your triangle and your magic stars, your magic sum is 10. One coin, so 1, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and then 6 plus 6. 1, 2, 3. So 3 is equal to 1 plus 6 is 7. 7 plus 3 is 10. So finally the sum is 10.
Finally, coming to the main part of the presentation. Impact of CT activities on students' learning. In the lockdown time, students, even elders, felt homesick. This Magic Triangle activity made them to overcome the scenario and got a chance to play with their parents. They developed mathematical skills of pattern recognition, abstract thinking, and algorithm skills like selection and elimination. It kindled their creativity. After practicing these types of activities, they were ready to accept the international challenges like Bebras without fear. I took initiative and motivated the students to participate in Bebras Challenge 2020, where 35 students participated and 4 students achieved the reward best of the school. Students also show interest in solving newspaper puzzles like Magic Square, Sudoku and so on. That means student approaches mathematics with confidence more casually without fear than before. Instead playing games and watching videos on mobile, they have fun with math puzzles. As they got the opportunity to discuss with their parents, grandparents, siblings, neighbors about the puzzle, they relate and coordinate with the traditional games like Pallanguri, Dayam, Pallatam and so on. As an impact, they formed mini club to play math games. Here, I wish to explain briefly about the great epic Mahabharatam famous Dayam game. Dayakattai is a board game played from ancient time in Tamil Nadu. There is no Mahabharatam without the incident of Dayam playing, where Gauravas defeated Pandavas in this game. The game is that each player have 6 coins. Move the coins from home to target as per the line given in the picture. Who reach all 6 coins first to the center is a winner. From the above game, students probed out CT skills also involved in traditional games like who is the winner, what is the winning position, how should the game be played when one player is considered out of the game. That is, one player cut all the 6 coins by the opponent player. The significant impact of the magic triangle made the students to find out CT skill in the traditional game. Before, people in the community played these traditional games without having awareness of mathematical skills and CT skills involved in it. Now, they have learnt what is CT skills, and also the CT skills in traditional games enables participants to engage in looking for the optimal strategy, pattern recognition, quick calculation, developing fine motor skills, eye-hand coordination and decision-making skill. Finally, I conclude that magic triangle activity made big boom travel, reaching CT skills from teacher to students and students to community. At last, I like to share the feedback. One of the parent of the student, Kirtika, said that instead of children sitting in front of the TV or smartphone for hours due to its addictive quality is only going to increase obesity and lethargic behavior. The other parent of the student, Bada Prakash, said no awareness about these games in the current generation. Teachers even suggest these games be introduced in schools. The sister of student, Madhumita, said many IT companies are now making use of these activities and games for the staff for leadership training or as de-stressors. Many start playing and remark that the game stimulates thinking capacity. One of our science teacher mentioned that Pallanguri, besides being a great way to strengthen mathematical concepts, is an excellent braille game as it involves touching and feeling. It is even prescribed to improve arthritis. One of my students, Swati, said that after doing this activity and playing these games, I became fast in adding numbers and increasing memory power. With this, I end my presentation and I thank one and all present here for giving this wonderful opportunity. Thank you. Thank you very much.